And it's so great to be a woman. We don't even have to wonder if we're looking good or not.
No.
We just know.
Because a random man on the street would tell us if we're hot or not hot.
Thanks, man.
That is awesome. That is award-winning musical comedy duo, The Fan Brigade, who are currently taking Kiwi comedy by storm. They hate cricket, but they love Mike McRoberts. What's not to love, really?
Yeah.
And they're about to hit this year's Best Food Comedy Gala to launch the 2018 New Zealand International Comedy Festival. Welcome to the cafe, Livvy and Amanda.
Yes.
Hello. Thank you for having us.
Livvy, let's start with you. Is it true that you guys are actually united via Twitter, or that's how you met?
Tell us about that. Basically, we followed each other. We thought each other were pretty funny, and she slid into my DMs one day.
creeped out on her and invited her up to stay at my house before we met.
Yeah.
And she did, so yeah. She's insane. It turned out she's from Huntley, so she was always excited to come to the big city.
Really excited. The whole way up was like,
oh. You know, a motorway.
Yeah, so I highly recommend meeting people on the internet and then just staying at their house before you meet them.
Well, you obviously clicked straight away when you were face-to-face, Amanda.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah. And 5 bottles of wine helped. No, we did. We hit it off right away, and it was pretty cool how it all worked out.
We wrote our first song that night. We didn't mean to, but
yeah.
Again, the 5 bottles of wine.
Yeah. It helped. Yeah.
So what was the first song that you wrote?
A love song to Tamati Coffee.
Oh, yes.
He's quite the stud.
Yes, and did you know the complexities of perhaps pursuing that relationship with Tamati?
No, but we're friends with him now.
Yeah. Oh,
good, yeah, good. We made it super awkward, and now he just has to
be friends with you.
No, yeah. The song is about how we're sad because he won't love us back for reasons.
Yes.
For valid reasons,
yes.
He won't love me the way I want to be loved.
One of your greatest clips is the cricket song. I mean, I really love that, but I've got a lot to ask you about that. So should we have a look at that right now?
Did you know that the game of cricket is called cricket? Because if you listen very closely, you'll hear crickets. Cricket is not even a sport, it's just a hobby. For people who hate hobbies, sports aren't supposed to have meal breaks or take 5 days. What else can you do with 5 days? Almost recreate the Six-Day War. Because countries have taken over other countries in less time than it takes to play cricket.
There is more could play, but we have to stop right there. Is there anything more you'd like to say about your hate of cricket, ladies?
It's valid. Oh. It's very valid.
We can't say it because it's daytime TV.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, what do you get flack? Do cricket fans come up to you and give you a bit of grief? Because cricket fans are very passionate about cricket.
Oh, they are. We've had a gentleman boo loudly through the entire song.
That could have been me that night.
It was hilarious, though.
I'm a cricket fan.
Yeah. Are you? Was that you?
Yeah, it could have been. We've got pink balls now and day-night tests.
Yes.
You know.
They're glazing over, mate. They're not interested.
Can you listen to me at cricket?
Can you give us an impression of playing cricket?
Oh, yeah.
But more boring.
Yeah.
Harsh.
Awesome.
Geez, I love you too. You're funny, and you can actually really sing, you too. You know, you're really, really talented. And I think it's quite hard to find comedians that can actually sing. So that's why this works so well. Let's talk about Mike McRoberts. We said in the intro you have a love for him.
Let's talk about him.
Yeah. You loved him even before seeing him.
Yeah.
Before seeing him with the shirt off. Remember the shirt off thing?
Yes.
Everyone remembers.
Yeah. That came out, and we're like, right.
Yeah. Well, we've been singing about this for a long time now.
We're trying to tell you. Yeah.
And didn't you have an awkward moment where you were singing about him and he was in the audience, so he actually was on stage with you?
Oh, it wasn't awkward.
He came to the show and we found that very confronting. But so we made him get up on the stage and we sang it to him.
Who was more embarrassed, you or him?
Him. Yeah.
I like to think he was flattered. Yeah.
He was horrified. He wasn't flattered.
I think he was.
He was traumatised.
No.
Well, not everybody has a song written about him. That's kind of cool.
That's right. He would have loved it.
It was romantic. It was a love song.
So speaking of the songs, how do you decide what to write about? Because Mike McRoberts, I'm sure, is pretty happy about that. Cricket is another great tribute. Do you just find things you hate and write about it? Is it a way to get it off your chest? Or do you find things, you know, how does it work?
Hate, love and don't care about and wine.
Strongly don't care about. What do you not care about is quite often how we start.
Like, yeah.
So what is the biggest thing that you're not caring about at the moment, apart from cricket?
Apart from cricket.
We don't care about diamonds a lot.
Okay.
Everyone else makes a big fuss of those, but they're not for us.
Not for us.
And what's what are we going to see in this new show of yours?
A little bit of our backstory.
Yeah. A little bit of real life stories, which nice. We haven't typically done too much of before.
Yeah. Just a little bit beyond our opinions. Ooh. Yeah, people want to really? Know more about us.
So tell us about the Comedy Gala.
Oh. It's great. There's going to be 20 to 22 acts. We're in it last year. It was just the best time. It's the best event of the year, I think. Who have we got? There's Arj Barker, of course. There's us, of course.
Sarah Callahan.
Yeah, Lauren Patterson.
Yeah.
Reese Mathewson, Di Hemward. Chopper.
Andrew Maxwell from Ireland.
So you go to one show and you get to get like snippets of everyone, don't you? You get to sort of like, it's like a little taster.
Yeah.
Like an entree.
Yeah. Auckland and Wellington.
You get to watch a little bit of everyone's, you know, like a little bit of their set and then see, you know, who's our shows
you're
you want
funny,
to go to.
You're not.
Yeah.
Funny.
Yeah, you get a tick sheet when you walk in the door. Yes, no. No way.
Well, and it's all objective, isn't it? Because people find different things funny, which is why a gala is quite a good experience.
Something for everyone.
Yeah, and did you guys ever think when you first started out over that wine after you drove up from Huntley that you would be part of the gala year after year? Did you ever think that
we hoped so.
Nice.
Yeah, yes. I used to watch it and be like, oh, man, because, like, I was real nerdy. I was really into comedy and they were, like, my rock stars. And it was, yeah, we're very excited to have it this early. I think, I mean, it would have been in our, like, long-term plan. But
Livvy's long-term plan. I was like, what's a gala?
Yeah.
Isn't that what you have at school? Hey, when I'm at school, I'm really looking forward to seeing it, especially after those clips. You look funny. And I want to see the bits that we can't play on morning TV as well. You can catch the Fan Brigade performing at this year's Best Foods Comedy Gala, which launches the 2018 New Zealand International Comedy Festival. This takes place in both Auckland and Wellington towards the end of the month. You can check out the Comedy Festival website for ticket details.